द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 11th, मैं संतोष प्रजापति, प्रवक्ता जीआरएस इंटर कॉलेज इंग्लिश की ऑनलाइन क्लास में आपका बहुत बहुत अभिवादन करता हूँ। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द फर्स्ट लेसन ऑफ प्रोज माई स्ट्रगल फॉर एन एजुकेशन विच हैज बीन रिटन बाय बुकर टी वाशिंगटन, अ निग्रो राइटर। First of all, I tried to make you understand what the main theme of this lesson. The lesson, My Struggle for an Education, shows us that we can achieve our aims successfully if we are determined to do the work diligently. In other words, if we are single-minded and have courage to face every difficulty, students, nothing is impossible in this world. You know, students, sincere efforts are always rewarded. Students, आप जानते हो, जहाँ चाह होती है वहाँ राह होती है। ये लेसन भी हमको यही सीख देने का प्रयास करती है कि किस तरीके से बुकर टी वाशिंगटन असंभव कार्य को संभव बनाते हैं। इस स्टोरी को अच्छे से सुनिए, अच्छे से समझिए। एक बार मैं इसको इंग्लिश में आपको एक्सप्लेन करता हूँ, फिर आपको हिंदी में समझाता हूँ, ताकि आप इस लेसन को अच्छी तरीके से समझें। द राइटर बुकर टी वाशिंगटन वॉज अ निग्रो राइटर एंड हिज फैमिली कंडीशन वॉज वेरी पिटिएबल। One day when the writer was working in a coal mine, he heard two coal miners talking about a great school for colored people. And the school was situated somewhere in Virginia. And the name of this school was Hampton Normal Agricultural Institute. When the writer heard the beautiful description about Hampton Normal Agricultural Institute, he at once decided to get admission in that school. But there was major problem before him. He did not know where it was. He did not know how he would reach there. But he made up mind that he would reach there. It was the autumn of 1872. His mother was troubled with fear that he could gain nothing out of his effort. But the writer resisted to go there. He did not listen to his mother. At last, her mother permitted him half-heartedly. He had very little money. His elder brother John also helped him all that he could. But his help was not sufficient. But the writer started his journey and left for Hampton with an ambition to get education there. He had a small cheap satchel containing few articles of clothing. The distance from Malden to Hampton. Malden was the hometown of the writer, and Hampton was his destination. In fact, the distance from his home to Hampton Normal Agricultural Institute was about 500 miles. He covered the distance by walking and begging ride both in wagons and in the cars. After many days, he reached the city of Richmond in Virginia. When he reached Richmond, he was completely tired, hungry, dirty. He had no money. The writer was out of money and unknown about the big city. He went here and there. He asked at several places for lodging, but all wanted money. And it was the thing which the writer did not have. He went on walking and walking in the street. At last, he came over a broad elevated sidewalk and crept under it and lied on the ground for the night. Next day, when he awoke in the morning, he found himself somewhat refreshed. And when he saw here and there, he found himself near a large ship being unloaded a cargo of pig iron. He at once went to the captain of the ship and asked him permission to give him permit to unload the vessel in order to get money for food. The writer worked for a long time on the ship. By working hard, he earned a lot of money. When he collected a lot of money, he went to the captain of the ship and thanked him for his kindness and started his journey. Without any unusual occurrence, he reached Hampton Normal Agricultural Institute. When he saw three stories brick school building, he felt himself to have been rewarded for all that he had faced in order to reach there. The sight of the school gave him a new life full of hope. The writer went to the head teacher for admission, but he could not attract the head of the institution. He was very hungry, tired, and dirty. I think the head of the institution thought him a beggar. That is why she ordered him to sweep the recitation room. Getting her order, the writer became very happy. He took the broom and swept the recitation room three times delightfully and dusted all the woodwork around the walls, every bench, table, desk, floor, closet four times. Because the author felt that his future depended upon the impression. After some time, the work was over. The writer went to the head teacher and reported him about the work. The head teacher was a Yankee lady. She knew where the dust would be. So she came into the room and inspected the floor, closet, the woodwork around the wall. When she was unable to find a particle of dust, she took out her handkerchief and she rubbed her handkerchief on the table and benches. At last, she was pleased much with his work, and she gave him admission. At that time, when the writer got admission in the institution, he felt himself to be one of the happiest souls on the earth, because he had succeeded in the examination and his ambition was fulfilled. प्यारे बच्चों, ये एक इंग्लिश में आपके पूरे लेसन की एक समरी थी। अब इसी को एक बार मैं हिंदी में भी बताता हूँ, लेकिन आप इंग्लिश वाले को बार बार देखिए ताकि आपको ज़्यादा समझ में आए, और हिंदी से उसका अवलोकन करिए। नेक्स्ट वीडियो में मैं इसका हिंदी में आपको अनुवाद भी कुछ बताऊंगा कि आखिर क्या क्या है इस लेसन में। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, गुड नाइट।